In this vlog, you will see the Flutter Facebook login integration. So for which you need to add a dependency flutter_facebook_login, and the version is according to the latest available. So before getting into the coding, we need to create a project in a Facebook developer console. So here you can see I have already created a project here. So whenever you are creating for the first time, click on add new app, and from there you will be seeing options like this for the first time, and the first option will be login. So tap on the login, and here you can see I have created a project already. So I am getting this dashboard. So whenever you are creating for the first time, click on the integration Facebook login. So here I am just trying to show you a demo. So here you need to pass through a simple security check and tap on the submit button. Go through the documentation before doing so. So here this is a Facebook login. Tap on the setup button, and from here you will be shown the options like iOS, Android, website and others. Today we are dealing with iOS and Android. So here check according to your configuration the SDK and tap on the next button. Add your bundle ID here. So you can get the bundle ID in your manifest file for Android. So here this is my bundle ID, and I am tapping on save button. Click on continue and select single sign in according to your requirement and tap on next button. So here is a source code you need to add for your info.plist file, and tap on the next button. You will be directed to app delegate. So based on your configurations, add these codes. So next, click for the current login status. So before making a login, you need to check whether your device is already having a Facebook login active. So at last, ask for the permissions for the user to make the proper login. So, and these are the final steps you need to perform when you are making a move to App Store. So let us see through Android. So no need to download the Android SDK as we are dealing with the Flutter integration here. So here we will be adding the bundle ID here and click on the save button. And here one thing you need to check in, we are also giving the default activity class name also the same bundle ID. Generally we perform here the activity we will specify here whenever you are doing with the Android Facebook login, but now I am providing the basic package name only. So use this package name I am specifying to Facebook console. So here you need to generate a key hash, and this key hash you need to specify in this particular block here. So once you specify the key hash, I have already added my key hash. So let us go through our current project. So here I have added my key hash already. So I am moving further, and here you can see after adding the key hashes, here you need to add these things to your Android manifest file. So copy them and add it, and this particular files to your string.xml, and tap on the next button. So these are all the methods which you make to check whether the Facebook SDK initializations and activate app. But make sure we are doing this Facebook login through Flutter, so you don't need to add this particular code. So let us go through the project now. So here we are implementing a plugin Flutter Facebook underscore login. So here we have provided a login method. If you see, it's an asynchronous method where we are waiting for the result, and out of result we are fetching the details of the user here. So for example, like token, user ID, expires permission, declined permissions, and if the login is not successful, we will be moving the user to the error field here, error case, and if we cancel, then we will be moving the user to this particular case. So now let us try to log in and check the output. So here you can see the basic buttons for login and logout. So tap on the login button here. So you will be redirected to the Facebook login page. And here one more thing you need to take care. So whenever you are trying to make a Facebook login, so here you need to create your own test users. By default, a default test user will be created, and you can add some more test users using the add button here. And make sure that whenever you are trying it, you need to log in through the test users only. You cannot directly log in with your Facebook ID. So this is under still in development mode. So we need to only log in with the test users provided by the Facebook. So make sure this one, don't forget that you try to perform a login for the first time. So here I am performing a login with my test user only and clicking on the continue button. So here you can see the project Android coding routine which we have created. So here you can see we have successfully logged in to our account using the test user account. Here you can see the details, the token, user ID and expiry date and permissions which we took for profile users, friends and email, and declined permissions or nothing, and you can log out once your session is completed. And here you can see the status logged out. So this is the way we implement Flutter login. So this is a basic implementation. In coming tutorials, we will see some more integration tutorials for Facebook where we will also specify the user image on user login and some more additional features. So if you like this tutorial, do like, share and subscribe to our channel, and the code for this tutorial and the project creation is available in the link below description.